Hello, my name is Ina, and this video will be about Japanese fintech conference called FinSAM. You might already know that Japan was the first country adopting crypto in a payment industry. So this is why we can assume that Japan is setting trend for the whole world. And this time, I decided to go to this big FinSAM conference in Tokyo. I made my little research and discovered that 10,000 attendees will be there during these 4 days of the conference. First FinSAM event took place 3 years ago. During this time, this fintech conference grew out to be the largest in Japan and one of the largest in Asia. So I decided I need to go there to find out what trends are booming in Japan and what we have to be ready in the following years. So the FinSAM event started on the 25th of September in central Tokyo. It took 4 days and 6 different venues for us to have a very busy program. The program consisted of symposium, exhibition, pitch contests, workshop and ideathon. Also, there was a very intriguing part of this event, which was called the Person of FinSAM 2018. There were young startup leaders which had to pitch why they have to get 20 billion Japanese yen, which is around 200,000 of American dollars for their startup. And what's the price for the tickets? The usual price for FinSAM event is 100,000 Japanese yen, which is around 900 American dollars. And also there was a very nice thing. They made a discount for students who want to learn more about fintech industry. And these guys could buy tickets for 10,000 Japanese yen, which is around $90.
And now let me quickly share with you my notes and highlights from the symposium part. FinSAM 2018 was organized by SBI Corporation and Nikkei newspaper. The conference was opened by the speech of Mr. Yoshitaka Kitao, who is the CEO of SBI Holdings Corporation. SBI Group of Companies is one of the biggest Japanese financial corporations and prominent player in fintech industry. Mr. Yoshitaka Kitao talked about virtual currency trends and challenges. On the screen you can now see the keynote of the speaker, so I'll try to briefly explain some of this to you. I would like more information about this event to be presented in English online because this material is highly valuable. Most of the speeches were in Japanese, so I needed to use an in-ear translation. But as you can see, all the keynotes are only in Japanese, which is totally understandable but still a bit disappointing for us. During his speech, Mr. Kitao disclosed the current investment destination, the future investment schedule, and the roadmap of the virtual currency exchange industry. Mr. Kitao is also strongly confident in the actual demand expansion of the virtual currency. Talking about the high volatility of the virtual currency, he emphasized the importance of stabilizing and growth in money transfers and trade finance. As it is expected, the development of SBI blockchain businesses will be accelerated by the settlement of Ripple and R3 litigation matters, which had become a major problem in crypto adoption area so far. Mr. Kitao is a stakeholder of both companies, so he is promoting reconciliation because only this will make any other future business development possible. Also, Mr. Kitao said SBI will extend the blockchain business beyond the financial businesses. They are planning to use blockchain in real estate, retail, medical, distribution, manufacturing, legal affairs, and administrative causes. In order to make this happen, they are using the SBI AI and Blockchain Fund, which was established in January of 2018 and which is mainly investing in the AI and blockchain fields. In addition, 27 companies already made a decision to invest about 12 billion yen in implementing blockchain in non-financial industries. Combined with SBI investment, 18 billion yen will be in total invested in blockchain and AI fields. I personally would like to count how many times a word blockchain was pronounced during this 40-minute speech. Considering this man is one of the most important people in Japanese business, my personal conclusion is that Japan is again way ahead of the rest of the countries with using blockchain.